This is another mega deal involving OpenAI. What do we know about it?
Yeah, there are a lot of deals going on in AI right now, and OpenAI really is at the heart of so many of them. So OpenAI has been, Sam Altman and OpenAI have been diversifying their suppliers in a number of key areas. In the chip space in particular, everybody is pretty dependent on NVIDIA. Of course, NVIDIA now the most valuable company in the world. Partly that's because everybody has to buy their chips to be able to train these AI models and mostly to run them so far. That's given them incredible margins, you know, huge profits and revenue growth. So in this case, we're seeing Altman and OpenAI trying to diversify on the chips front, where they've looked at AMD, one of the competitors to NVIDIA in the past, and now they're talking with Amazon about using Amazon's chips within their operations too. That would probably bring their costs down a fair bit, and it makes it more competitive for NVIDIA to be able to bid and get its chips into the OpenAI data centers.
But so, you know, what does this mean for Amazon's AI chip ambitions? Because this is something that they've also highlighted.
They've been trying to push this very hard. Amazon, of course, is the leader in cloud computing services, the traditional variations that we saw before AI services. Now you're seeing a lot of competition in AI cloud services in particular, and Amazon is a step behind. They're trying to use their chips, the Trainium chips, to be able to catch up a bit. They think that that's a valuable offer for a lot of the AI companies out there, and they think that this would be, you know, a significant step. Being able to get OpenAI to be able to buy these chips would be a big step forward. For them.
In China, another homegrown chip company having a hugely successful IPO. What do we know about MetaX?
Yeah, not to be confused with Meta, the company in California. This is MetaX. It's a chip company that just went public in China. And you're seeing some incredible stories within the Chinese chip space, speaking of competition in AI chips. So MetaX went public. Its shares went up almost 700%. Its market cap is now $47 billion. It's a big company. It's significant. And most of us have never heard of it before. This comes just shortly after another company, MoreThreads, went public and also reached a valuation of about that level. So I think it shows the intense retail interest, retail investor interest in these kinds of chip companies within China, because they know that most NVIDIA chips cannot be sold into China at this point. There's a big opportunity for local players to be able to supply the local market and make some big revenue from it. The multiples on these stocks, though, are kind of out of this world, much higher than NVIDIA's.
Peter, I mean, it was almost like a year ago that, you know, we heard about DeepSeek, and people in the know really knew about it, but some of, like, you know, the common mortals hadn't really heard about it. What do we know so far about where China is with chips and AI?
Well, they're making progress. They're still very far behind, I'd say, on both of those fronts, particularly on chips. They have a long ways to catch up to NVIDIA. You've seen CEO Jensen Huang make the case that he wants to be able to sell more chips into China. He got the blessing to sell these H200 chips, but there's still a market there, and still, they're still quite a bit behind. On the AI services front, it's quite a bit different. DeepSeek, Alibaba, the other leaders within the China market are really taking the open source route. They're looking not so much at building these enormous data centers and trying to make a lot of money from those services. They want to do open source. They want to go lower cost route to be able to get AI integrated into business operations much more quickly. That, of course, is with the support and the blessing of the Beijing government.
But Peter, when you look at how they're trying to actually spur domestic demand for chips, I mean, is this going to be the big story for China in 2026, that this will be a success?
They're making progress, and this is a big policy debate in Washington right now, whether the Chinese domestic players, really led by Huawei Technologies, to be clear. Huawei is really the leader. There's a smaller company, Camricom, that is also competitive within that space, but they're going to be the leading providers. They need to have their chips manufactured by SMIC, which is kind of the TSMC of China. Mm-hmm. They're quite a bit behind TSMC, unfortunately, for those companies. So we'll see whether they're able to make progress. I mean, the argument from Jensen Huang and David Sachs in the White House is they're going to be forced to catch up on the domestic front if we don't supply them some of these chips, and that would taper their interest in buying domestic chips.